Hello again. Andrew Gossage from UP Global Sourcing is with us here at the Proactive Investor Studio in London. Warm welcome to you, Andrew. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Standing for Ultimate Products.
That's right.
Tell investors what the UP story is. What do you do?
Well, we're 20 years old as a business, and we are, as we say, a product business. General merchandise, products predominantly for the home. And we operate very much in that kind of mass market area. We pride ourselves on products for every family.
Tell us about the history of the company. There have been quite a few incarnations, haven't there?
There has. It was founded 20 years ago by Sam Showman, who's the CEO. And it started off as a pure trading business, originally in blinds, imported from the USA. And it's gone through a few stages. At one point it was a general importer. And about sort of 15 years ago, Simon went to the Far East, and that's when we started our sort of China supply business. Moving on, we then decided back in 2013 to focus on our brands. We'd accumulated a number of really nice British heritage brands.
And familiarise us with those brands, if you would.
So, yeah, we have brands like Beldre, which dates back to 1876, which is we use for laundry and for floor care. We have brands like Salter, which is 250 years old. We have an audio brand called Intempo. And we have a Lancastrian heritage brand in bakeware called Progress. And this year we acquired the Clean Easy brands, which is nearly 100 years old. And we're in the process of relaunching that for floor care and for laundry.
Now you've got four pillars as far as your growth strategy is concerned.
Yeah.
One of which is the major UK supermarkets.
Yeah.
We'll go into that in just a second, but tell us what those four growth pillars are.
So four pillars: discounts, UK supermarkets, online and international. So as I say, we have branded products that we pitch at the everyday consumer. So good for discounts, but also good for UK supermarket. That's still where most families shop every weekend.
And you've got a unique selling point there, haven't you? A way of helping them create greater revenues.
Yes, I mean, it's what we do with our retailers is we want them to achieve their own label margin, despite the fact that it's a branded product. Often brands will not give the retailer the margins they require. We want to pitch our product at a space either on or just above their own label price points, but they still get their own label margin.
And the other two pillars that we were just finishing off with, international and online.
That's right. So online is, before we focused on our brands, we didn't really carry inventory. So now we are focused on our brands, we carry our core ranges in stock, and that has opened up online as a channel for us. And last year it was 8% of revenue, up from virtually nothing a few years before. And then international, we're pretty mature in the UK. We want to expand our products out internationally, and particularly into Europe, with a particular focus on Germany.
So from an investor point of view, now they know the general story, what about overheads, costs, burn rate, and indeed plans for growth into 2019?
Well, everything we do is low cost. If we're going to hit those price points for the everyday consumer, then we have to manage our overheads tightly, we have to source our products very cost effectively, and we acquire our brands in a cost effective way as well. We want to be mass market. That's the space we operate in.
And a nice blend of yields as well. Tell us what they are.
In terms of our share price, we do have a yield at the moment in excess of 6%, two times covered, and our policy is to distribute 50% of our profit after tax as dividend each year.
And your balance sheet is quite strong?
Yeah, very happy with the balance sheet. We have strong balance sheet. We have plenty of headroom within our bank facilities. As I say, we two times cover our dividends. So, yeah, good balance sheet, we feel.
Andrew, imagine we're going to sit here in a year from now. What are you going to be telling me? What are the plans?
Well, we had a tough year last year. FY18 was tough, but it did finish in a more promising fashion. And we have started FY18 with a better order book than last year. So we'll see how it goes. It's still a very tough market for non-food in the UK, but we're encouraged by where we're going.
Andrew Gossage, great pleasure to talk to you. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.